Alrighty. What's going on, guys? We're back. Today, we're going to play something different. We got a new game called Kentucky Route something. It is called Kentucky Route Zero TV Edition. It's like a story game. So I believe we're just going to hop right into this game and try it out. So, Kentucky Route Zero. From what I understand, this game's very, very much like a story game. Like a point-and-click adventure, almost. So, yeah, I'm excited to see what it is and what it's like. Act 1. Scene 1. I don't know how to say that. Ekis. So this is it. We could walk around. So we have our truck. We have our dog, who seems like a really old dog the way he walks. And we have this dude sitting here, the attendant. See our truck. A moving truck rumbles softly to itself. Painted on its side are the words, Lizette's Antiques. Furniture, glassware, curiosities. So we're driving an antique truck. My dog, an old hound in a straw hat, both have seen better days. So we're talking about our dog with the dog is wearing a hat, like an old hat. I don't see the hat on the silhouette, but it's there, I promise. The attendant. So Joseph sits between gas pumps in a Queen Anne armchair. His hair is gray and his glasses are darkened. So he's wearing like sunglasses. Joseph. Damn, did you hear that wreck? Truck full of bottles. I don't know. Beer bottles? Whiskey? Lost a tire or something, and spilled booze and glass all over the interstate. What a mess. I hope they don't come down here looking for anything. We blew a damn fuse and it's all shut off. Did I hear a dog? What's your dog's name? So I guess Conway is my character. So I could say, I don't know his name. His name's Blue. His name's Homer. Homer Simpson. Bit of a shuffle or a drag in Homer's step. Kind of an old one, isn't he? Well, I guess he's got some stories then. Hey, there's some jerky for Homer. I made it myself. Didn't turn out too well. But I bet a dog will eat it. Nice, give my dog some free treats. Getting late, right? I could feel the sun on my neck. I bet it's just a few feet off the horizon. I've been driving all evening looking for Five Dogwood Drive. Or I've got a delivery to make on Dogwood, but I'd rather watch the sunset. Let's do Dogwood Drive. Hey, I understand. You've got to do your job you're paid to do. Maybe get some rest somewhere in there. Maybe have a drink. Then back at it. There's dignity in that rhythm. So he respects my hard-working attitude. So where is Dogwood Drive? How long have you been working here? What's your rhythm like? if I just straight up ask him, where's Dogwood Drive? That's a little like, I feel like it's just saying, you know, hey, tell me where I need to go. This one, starting up a conversation, and then what's your rhythm like? It's kind of like bouncing off of what he just said. So I feel like in reality, in my life, I would want to continue the conversation, right? What's your rhythm like? Oh, I just like to listen to the TV. I used to do a lot of poetry on the computer, but I don't have the ear for it lately. Listen, you and Homer would have been driving up and down 65 all night. Dogwood Drive is on the other side of, well, to get there, you've got to take the zero. That's ominous, the way he said it. The zero is a tough route to find, but you can use my computer to look up the directions. You'll have to head down into the basement and reset the circuit breaker first. I'll be happy to have those whining lights back up anyways. It's too damn quiet here, out here. The basement door is back there in the office. Appreciate your help, friend. Oh, and here, take this lamp. It gets dark. Well, we got a lamp. Oh, I can turn the lamp off. Okay. Into the basement. Okay. So we have the basement. Emily, Ben, and Bob sit in folding chairs behind a worn card table. Papers, oddly shaped dice, and highway map covered the table. What? So wait, oh, these people are in the dark? Okay. Let's go see this sign real quick. A dusty, rusty sign is bolted onto the wall. These are the rules. 1. No open flames near the gasoline. 2. No consumption of beer or spirits on the premises. 3. In case of sudden darkness, do not panic. Relax. Count backwards from 5. Strictly limit time spent in the basement to fewer than 3 minutes of every hour. Really? Why would that be a rule? Only be in the basement for 3 minutes. Conway clears his throat. Have y'all seen a breaker down here? Or, oh, sorry. Didn't know there was anyone down here. I think that one. Did you hear something? No, sorry. I was looking at the rules again. It gets easier as you go. Look, you said you rolled a 5, right? That means you get to pick up your marker and move it to anywhere on the map. So it's your turn now, right? Oh yeah, I guess so. Where'd you put that 20-sided die? I don't see it. Did you drop it? It should be easy enough to find. It glows in the dark. So these dudes are playing a game in the dark. I guess I can't go any farther. Can't go down. Talk to him again. But gets no response from the people at the table. Conway. I just need to get by you for a minute. Or did you lose something? I'm gonna ask. Nah, well, should we help them find what they lost? I think it rolled down off the left there, but I don't see it. Well, I'm not going to go looking for it. It's too dark down there. One of you go down and get it. I'll just study the rules. Okay. Does that mean it's over here? Same sign. Okay, cool. So if you hold B, you can skip Or fast forward the talk. Let's just see this. I think you were right about the instant crisis rolls. There's a whole separate table of them in the back. I don't like that rule anyway. It's not fun. It's just random and frustrating. The randomness is what makes it realistic, Bob. Alright, so they're still not letting me buy. I really need to get the power back on and make this delivery. I still don't understand how you win. Roll the 20-sided die once for each player and refer to Appendix C, Table of Psychogeographical Anxiety / Address Correlations. Locate the result street addresses on the roadmap and move each player marker to the appropriate location. That doesn't help. I don't think you can win. It says on the box, it's a tragedy. You said you're missing a piece? Just to get started, we need the 20-sided die. You'll roll a 1, you drive into a ditch. If you roll a 2, or a 9, or a 12, you have to write down a newly anxiety and roll again. If you roll a 5, you get to move your piece anywhere on the map you want. Go get that die. It's too dark down there. Well, that should make it easy. The damn thing glows in the dark. Wait. I was supposed to turn off my light to find it. I get it. Conway picks up the glowing 20-sided die and inspects it. The number 5 is facing up. Just a small piece of plastic, but it has a reassuring, almost comforting weight. He places the object in his jacket pocket. Okay. Are the people going to be gone now? That would be good. They are gone. I knew it. Folding chairs are arranged a worn card table. The chairs are empty and the surface of the table is bare. Conway places the 20-sided die on the table. I found it for them. The power is on. Hey, Joseph, I'm here. There it is. Just listen to those lights whine. Yep. Well, I'd better get those directions and head to the zero. If you don't mind. Computer's in the office. You're looking for the Marquez. She knows her way around those roads. She'll get you to the zero. The password is, damn. I usually just feel it out. Muscle memory, you know? It's kind of long, kind of like a short poem, I think. One of those short poems that really sums it all up. You'll figure it out. I hope I can figure it out. Was I supposed to go in the basement? Said it's in the office. Ah. waking the computer from its reverie. Reverie? Password. Nobody saw the accident. I wonder if it would just say password accepted no matter what you pick. Joseph, how's it going in there? Figuring it all out? Sure you are. Messages, address book, games, or exit? I think we're gonna go for the address book. So he said Marquez, dude. I think we do Marquez. Maybe not. Okay, whatever. The Marquez residence. 100 Macondo Lane. Head northeast on 65. Turn left as soon as you see that ugly tree that always on fire. Look for the barn at the base of the mountain there. Can't miss it. Got it? Out there on Macondo somewhere, right? Yeah, that's it. Hey, look, while you were down there, I loaded that old TV of mine into your truck. I borrowed that thing from Weaver Marquez a number of years ago. And now that the power is all weird over here, I can't pick up anything but static and public access anyways. She was always more of a reader, but maybe she'd want it back at home. It's a nice TV. Alright. Sun's gone down. You and Homer better get on that road if you're gonna make your delivery. Yes. You are right, Homer. Take it easy, Homer. Let's go. Conway moves on. Yes. Oh, dude, I am lost. I was supposed to be paying attention to this stuff. See if any of this... if any of this sparks my memory. Louisville Road. Oh, man, we're gonna have to go back and look at the directions again. Damn it. I'm bad. Oh, there's a scene too. There's more people here. Joseph and a stranger. Can I use his computer? Yes. Okay. Oh, I can't look at the map again. We're not going to read his message. I don't want to mess it up, you know? What is this? Okay, and that's only a few miles outside of Hodgenville. Anyways, I don't think you could do much better for accessibility. And they got that new gas station if folks gets lost, if get lost. But maybe they should feel lost, Joseph. Just as lost as then when we are already feeling lost? What? Just like poor itinerant Silas wandering the road looking for a home. Well, that's a way to look at it, I guess. Well, hello. I heard that old truck rumble up. How's Homer? Say, maybe you can help this fellow. He's looking for a venue, is how you say it, right? I know a furniture warehouse you could probably break into. No. It can't be indoors. Impossible. But I'm obliged you'd stop a moment to help me work this through. Let me explain my charge. I've dedicated my life 12 years to the design and orchestration of my life's great work. A grand, broadly experimental theatrical adaptation of The Death of Hired Man. Of the Hired Man by Robert Frost. Okay. What? How do you mean experimental? Well, drama is really my second love. My heart calling is pseudoscience. Who doesn't love pseudoscience, really? Yep, pseudoscience. Pseudoscience is the eternally fruitful marriage of whimsy and process that has yielded such poetic specimens as astrology, phrenology, canals on Mars, homeopathic medicine. I hope I have the time to explain how my pseudoscientific theory poetry poetics finds expression in this play. But now I am in the delirious rush. The event is to be performed tomorrow morning, just before dawn. But in the spirit of tragedy, our venue fell through at the last moment. I've been out all day driving the highways looking for a replacement. Eyes fastened to the landscape like a hawk scouring the field. So like a hawk, in fact, that I failed to keep an eye on my gas meter. I'm here waiting for the tow truck to bring my car so I can get back to the task. Well, I don't mind keeping an eye out for a spot. I'm on a drive anyways. If you have attention to spare, it'd be grateful. Somewhere outdoors, somewhere intimate, somewhere tragic. Okay. Joseph, well, here you are. Here I am. Yep. I'm hard at work, as you can see. Now, don't distract me. You like your work? I haven't got a lot of options. Well, who has options these days, you know? I went to college for almost 12 years. I have an advanced degree in electronic writing. But I guess I took the low road in the end. Okay. So, I don't know how we're going to find the directions if his computer won't let me do it. His computer won't let me look at the map again. So, I don't remember where I'm supposed to go. Oh, here we go. Head northeast on 65 and turn left as soon as you see the ugly tree. Northeast. So that's up to the right on the 65. Do you think it's on Louisville Road? Burning tree. A tall black oak burns on a hill above the road. And then it said, turn left as soon as you see that ugly tree that's always on fire. So this is left. Hey, we found it. Whew. Act 1, Scene 3. The Marquez Farmhouse. Should we talk to Homer? Pretty dark out here, huh? So I guess we just head up the path here. The farmhouse is up on the hill a bit. Maybe you'd better stay down here where it's lit. We'll have him stay. Alright. Old dog, please don't get hurt while I'm gone. A street light. A street lamp lights the base of a dusty path leading up the hill. Your boy cannot read English. There's a graveyard. A family graveyard is set off to the side of the house. Headstones are inscribed with the surnames of the unfortunate Norakowski, Padilla, Marquez. Marquez is the person I'm trying to meet. Turn on the light switch. Why is this lady standing in the dark? I was just thinking, what a lovely house we have. Do you like it? Have you been here before? Did you happen to see an owl? I didn't see an owl. I did hear an owl. I've never been here before. I know. It must seem very strange to you. I was here when this house was built. So it's never been strange to me. There used to be another house here, but we had it destroyed, and we built this one. It was very expensive, and we got quite underwater. What do you do for work? Is it too difficult, or do you like it very much? I was once a mathematician. Are you looking for something in particular here? I'm looking for the zero. Oh, you're lost. And that old blind man sent you. Is that right? Of course he did. He's nice. Did he say anything nice about me? Did he send along a gift? He asked me to return this TV set of yours. Will you please set it up? Then I can explain to you how to get where you're going. The zero. I know. Set up the TV, then. That's not how it's supposed to look. You've made a mistake setting it up. It is a foreign object to you. Which of your parents was it who wouldn't allow you to watch television? Dad thought it was a radioactive. I know how to set up a TV. You know, let's play the character here. Ghosts. Yeah, that's creepy. I know about that. She was 11. Oh, she was ill. Wasn't she? Mentally. I mean, kind of distant, fearful. Yeah, that's a way to put it. You have it all backwards. I'm not surprised. Are you? Have you been paying attention? I don't think you have. It's time to start paying attention now, Conway. Look closely at the television. Bro, this game's pretty cool. Hey, wake up. You spaced out for a minute there. The picture on the TV. That TV is picking up the wrong signal. My cousin Shannon would know more about it. She fixes TV for a living. Well, she used to. I think the new models are giving her some trouble. So, I really just need to get to the zero. Honestly, I'm not convinced you should bother with the zero. I'd much rather you find my cousin and fix my TV. But I'll get you headed the right way. So it's pretty easy. Get back on 65 heading north, then take the first right after the artificial limb factory. From there, your arrival at the zero is basically inevitable. Nice to know you, Conway. Keep your eyes open, especially in the dark. All right. Is she gonna be gone now? Yeah, she disappeared. That's crazy. All right, was she there? Just like the people in the basement. Were they really there? Let's look at the stove here. A disused wood-burning stove is set up in one ash-dusted corner of the room. It's cold to the touch. Oh, the sink. Okay, I accidentally clicked the exit, I guess. I hope my little dog Homer is doing okay. Who are these people playing music? I just met the strangest lady. She kind of creeped me out, Homer. But that's not her fault, I guess. Some folks are just like that. Conway is ready to leave. Okay. So, go back on the 65, heading north. Then take the first right after the artificial limb factory. Is this the artificial limb factory? A creek runs alongside the highway and then turns towards a dirty brick building. A grinding drone from within the building is faintly audible from the interstate. Floodlights on the lawn illuminate smokestacks. At the edge of the building's parking lot, a large sign, partly obscured by trees, reads, artificial limb factory. So this is it, right? And the note says, the first right after the artificial limb factory. So right here. So do you think this is it? It's gotta be that other one. On ramp? Act 1, Scene 4. Elkhorn Valley. Omer. How's it going, Homer? Not sure that lady was right about the on-ramp to the zero being here. Or, hey, you got something on your hat? Did you pick that up on the road? You like it out here, don't you? Picking up strange dirt on the road? Okay. I guess we go check out whatever this is. Act 1, Scene 5. That was a short scene. Elkhorn. Mine. Who's that? Shannon speaks into the large brick cell phone held up to her ear. It's $200 for 2 weeks. It kind of is an emergency, or it's fine. I'll figure it out. I guess he can't kick me out for another week or two. Can I trust him not to just change the lock? Okay, you're right. Just never mind. Shannon hangs up the phone and puts it away. Excuse me, ma'am. I saw the light was on and I'm looking for an on-ramp too. Are you here to kick me off the property? Do you believe in ghosts? There we go. Well, let's see. I do believe a place can be haunted, if that's what you mean. What about a person? Can a person be haunted? Sure, I guess a person could. Sometimes I feel haunted myself. What haunts you? Bad decisions, I guess. Wasted youth? Well, look. Here's what it is. I drive deliveries for a shop called Lizette's Antiques. And I'm out trying to finish this job. You're making a delivery to the mine? No. I have a delivery for 5 Dogwood Drive. And I can't remember ever seeing that address before. Now I heard I need to take a highway called the Zero. So I met this young lady near name of Weaver Marquez. And she sent me this way. And so here I am. Uncommon kind of place for an on-ramp. But that's what it's been like so far anyways with... What? The zero? Is that around here? I've never heard of the damn zero. That doesn't sound like a real highway. But I know Weaver. I've known her all my life. She was my cousin. I'm Shannon Marquez. Weaver doesn't lie. One time, when we were younger, she told me my dad had been in a terrible car wreck. There were crushed metal everywhere, and we'd been hearing an echo through the house for years. She said, I was very upset, crying, and then my dad walked in the door, just come back from a trip to the junkyard collecting scrap metal to fashion into wind chimes. I was angry. But she said it wasn't a joke, and I wasn't a lie. At the time, I thought she meant it as a riddle or a puzzle. But Weaver's not a puzzle. She's a mystery. So maybe the zero is down here somewhere? Maybe it is. Well, I won't mind the company. I've got business down here myself. I talked to Weaver earlier this evening, too. Or anyway, she talked to me. It's hard to tell if she's listening sometimes. Weaver told me I had to come down here to the old Elkhorn mine. She said I'd find something I've been looking for. Where did you see Weaver? At my workshop. She just appeared. I hadn't seen her since a long time. It's not such a bad thing, you showing up now, all told. I'd rather not go down there alone. Your dog should stay up here, though. It's not a place for a dog. This is an old mine. It runs pretty deep and tangled. If we're going to go down into it, find your on-ramp or whatever else, we've got to keep our bearings. I don't want to get turned around. I've got some gear here to measure conductivity, frequency response, stuff like that. Maybe you can find a way to put a signal out ahead, do some analysis, and figure out what kind of topology we're up against. Sure, let's look around. All right, so before we go in here, I think what we will do, save the game or be done for now, right? So, yeah, pretty cool game so far. Not a whole lot. It's kind of mysterious, a little weird. But something tells me this is one of those games that just kind of stays that way. Probably will finish the story and have no idea what the hell happened. But it's cool. I'm having fun. And it is like I like these kind of games. They're like mysterious, cool games, you know? A little different than what you usually play. But fun. But yeah, pretty cool. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comment what you guys think. What should I do different? If you don't want to see any more of this. But yeah, I'll see you guys later. You guys have a good night.